Worse than the sunflower, she said. But the new dimension of truth had only recently burst in on us. I mean, now it was to be condemned. And in the vagrant shadow, her mothball truth was eaten in the cold. Like it or not, shadow, the humdrum was consumed. Tired housewives began it some decades ago. A small piece of cake, that is, it was honey lips. There's also millions of miles filling the place reserved for it. You see how honey crumbles your universe, which seems like an institution. I mean, how many more walls do you need, baby? Because then everything in her belief was to be submerged. And soon, there was no life you could live out to its end, and no attitude which, in the end, would save you. The monkish and the frivolous alike would be trapped in death's capacious claw. But listen, well, I tell you about the wall, baby. There was a key to everything in that oak forest. It was a sad one. You see, ever since childhood, there's been this special meaning to everything. You smile at your friend's joke, but only later through tears and shoe pinches. Even though it fits perfectly, apples remain to be gathered also. The whole host of the world's ailments and troubles, there is no time like the present for giving into this temptation. Once the harvest is in, the animals put away for the winter to stand at that uncomprehending window, cultivating the desert with salt tears, which will never do anyone any good. My dearest, I am as a galleon on salt billows, perfuming my head with forgetting all around me. For someday I know these projects will return in a beautiful voyage over ice cream seas like the end of you. Who wake up forgetting already daylight shakes you in the yard, the hands remain empty, their construction holds your basket just now. Darkness is taking root anew with intense activity. You shall never have seen it just this way, and I swear that is your reward. These days, fine vapors escape from whatever is doing and living the night. It's cold and delicate and full of angels. Pounding down on that which is still doing and living, the factories are all of us. Chimes, they go on her. You and I, we're together, at last, but far apart. Sometimes we all find empty skies, and when we do, we fill it with what's left of our laughter and the big gulp narratives. It's the moment we attempt to anchor our emptiness to the flesh of any star strange enough to share the madness we normally reserve for the belly of the beast we harbor inside our trust. Look, listening never was my forte. There was more echo in the way he left than most silences I've ever had the panic of experiencing, and I swear, I meditated in the hush you left behind. I wasn't done when I heard the door slam. But in the calm of those moments, I remembered things, like when you said, meet me by the swimsuit. In the silence and the darkness that precedes the fall, I mentioned, dangling mischief off the edge of my nowhere, I found you. You were my brightest discovery, I called you song. You wanted verses, so I crossed my fingers in cognac and let my hands get past the poems I collected under your collar normally. I find my poems, the bottles of empty bottles, the lines fall out of you like drunken secrets. So I stuck around, shook Chicago from your spine, wrote your sheets, music, but I swear I never saw you in notes. I saw shapes that I knew could never be memorized. I saw poems. Saw poems after poems after poems, poems. The milk crate mornings, when our tongues tasted like yesterday. window, hoping you'd let the cold in. You thought I was wildfire, I was worried about that. The nights you wanted me for everything. The nights you wanted me for everything, and then still wanted poems with the only poem I could ever remember to tell you, the only one. I will ever write you for the poems that sounded like home, like sanity, like something we have both been searching for too long. For the nights you never called, the nights you said nothing, the nights you said fuck me, called my name like a seizure for weeks, where you never returned the favor. The day when I finally realized I wasn't chasing you, we're never on the same page. Somewhere in the process of putting you down on the paper, the ink began to run. So I held my words up to your landline, hoping their honesty would help you sleep. Well, I spent the nights wide-eyed in search of lullabies, but I'm tired, so you... Listen.